Welcome dear students to online classes. We were discussing the chapter A Triumph of Surgery, where we read about Tricky, a dog who was overfed by his mistress and who had become really fat and was unwell as he had been overfed by his mistress, Mrs. Pumphrey, and there was a veterinary surgeon, Mr. Harriet, who had come to rescue him. When he came to know that Tricky was completely unwell and was vomiting severely, was not taking his food, he thought that he should take him away from Mrs. Pumphrey's household, otherwise she would make him more ill by overfeeding him more and more. It was when Mr. Harriet brought Tricky along with him to the surgery. The first day Tricky did not move. The second day Mr. Harriet kept him on a water diet. And the third day, he could see some movement in Tricky when the other dogs of the surgery surrounded him and Tricky somehow tried to follow them. And while it was the time for all the dogs to have their food, they all jumped into their bowls so that the other dogs could not eat up their food. Tricky took a walk round the shining bowls, licking casually inside one or two of them. Next day, an extra bowl was put out for him, and I was pleased to see him jostling his way towards it. The next day, when Mr. Harriet put a bowl, extra bowl, for Tricky also, along with the other dogs, he was happy to see Tricky moving towards his bowl of food in a happy manner. From then on, his progress was rapid. After that, Tricky started becoming well. His condition started improving rapidly or fast. He had no medical treatment of any kind, but all day he ran about with the dogs, joining in their friendly scrimmages. All the dogs enjoyed playing games here and there, and Tricky joined them. He discovered the joys of being bowled over, trampled on, and squashed every few minutes. Tricky enjoyed all these dog fights, scrimmages, and being squashed and being trampled by the other dogs. You all must have seen how when two or three dogs get along, how heartily they just leap and get over each other and enjoy a lot. Similarly, Tricky enjoyed along with the other dogs at the surgery. Tricky became an accepted member of the gang, an unlikely silky little object among the shaggy crew, fighting like a tiger for his share at mealtimes and hunting rats in the old hen house at night. He had never had such a time in his life. All the while, Mrs. Pumphrey hovered anxiously in the background, ringing a dozen times a day for the latest bulletins. Now, meanwhile, Tricky was enjoying his stay at Mr. Harriet's surgery along with the other dogs. He was the cutest of all, and the other dogs were really grown up ones. But Mrs. Pumphrey was over worried and could not think of living without Tricky. And she called up dozen times to know about Tricky's health. I dodged the questions. Mr. Harriet says that he skipped the questions about whether his cushions were being turned regularly or his correct coat worn according to the weather. But I was able to tell her that the little fellow was out of danger and convalescing rapidly. What did Mr. Harriet mean? That he did not wish to answer and he skipped the questions regarding Tricky's quotes, regarding Tricky's cushions. But one thing that Mr. Harriet could surely tell Mrs. Pomfrey was that Tricky was recovering soon. The word convalescing seemed to do something to Mrs. Pomfrey. And Mrs. Pomfrey started to hope for the betterment of Tricky.